Hello everyone. Tonight is the final chapter of the book of Genesis. Let us begin, verse 1. Then Joseph fell on his father's face, and wept over him, and kissed him. And Joseph commanded his servants, the physicians, to embalm his father. So the physicians embalmed Israel. Then the 40 days to do this were fulfilled, because in this manner the days of embalming are fulfilled. And the Egyptians wept for him 70 days. Then the days of weeping for him were past. And Joseph spoke to the household of Pharaoh, saying, If now I have found favor in your sight, please speak in the ears of Pharaoh, saying, My father made me swear, saying, Behold, I am about to die. In my grave, which I dug for myself in the land of Canaan, there you shall bury me. So now, please let me go up and bury my father. Then I will return. And Pharaoh said, Go up and bury your father, as he made you swear. So Joseph went up to bury his father, and with him went up all the servants of Pharaoh, the elders of his household, and all the elders of the land of Egypt, and all the household of Joseph, and his brothers, and his father's household. They left only their little ones, and their flocks, and their herds in the land of Goshen. There also went up with him both chariots and horsemen, and it was a very immense camp. And they came to the threshing floor of Atad, which is beyond the Jordan. And they lamented there with a very great and immense lamentation. And he observed 7 days of mourning for his father. Now the inhabitants of the land, the Canaanites, saw the mourning at the threshing floor of Atad. And they said, This is an immense mourning for the Egyptians. Therefore, it was named Abel Mizraim, which is beyond the Jordan. Thus his sons did for him as he had commanded them. Indeed, his sons carried him to the land of Canaan and buried him in the cave of the field of Machpelah before Mamre, which Abraham had bought along with the field for his possession as a burial site from Ephron the Hittite. After he had buried his father, Joseph returned to Egypt, he and his brothers, and all who had gone up with him to bury his father. Then Joseph's brothers saw that their father was dead, and they said, What if Joseph bears a grudge against us, and returns back to us all the evil which we dealt against him? So they sent a message to Joseph, saying, Your father commanded before he died, saying, Thus you shall say to Joseph, Please forgive, I beg you, the transgression of your brothers and their sin. For they dealt evil against you. So now, please forgive the transgression of the slaves of the God of your father. And Joseph wept when they spoke to him. Then his brothers also came and fell down before him and said, Behold, we are your slaves. But Joseph said to them, Do not be afraid, for am I in God's place? As for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, in order to do what has happened on this day, to keep many people alive. So now, do not be afraid. I will provide for you and your little ones. And he comforted them and spoke to their heart. Now Joseph stayed in Egypt, he and his father's household, And Joseph lived 110 years. And Joseph saw the third generation of Ephraim's sons, also the sons of Machir, the son of Manasseh, were born on Joseph's knees. And Joseph said to his brothers, I am about to die, but God will surely take care of you and bring you up from this land to the land which he swore to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob. Then Joseph made the sons of Israel swear, saying, God will surely take care of you, and you shall carry my bones up from here. So Joseph died at the age of 110 years, and they embalmed him, and he was placed in a coffin in Egypt. And with that, we finally conclude the entire book of Genesis. Thank you all for being here. I love you all. Good night.